Today we have a guest reader, Piyu, Srisha's cousin, and she is going to read story about Krishna. So let's get started.
Hello friends, today I am reading a story of Krishna. Let's start. Krishna loved eating Mother Yashoda's handmade butter. He would always look for ways and means of getting more of the delicious butter. One day Krishna wanted to eat some butter. He, along with his friends, slowly made their way to the kitchen. As they peeped from behind the door, they saw that Mother Yashoda had hung the pot of butter from the ceiling so that Krishna could not lay his hand on it. What shall we do? Asked one of his friends. None of us is dead tall enough to take the pot down from there. Krishna started to gently stroke his chin and then cried to out, don't give up hope, just eat. I have an idea. Pushing his friends into the kitchen, Krishna started arranging his friends in the circle. He then made a few more friends get up on the shoulders of the boys standing below. As soon as his friends had taken their positions, Krishna then ran up their backs and quickly reached the top of the
human pyramid.
We have done it, cried a happy Krishna as he removed the lid of the pot and started scooping out the butter. Suddenly Mother Yashoda entered the kitchen and saw what was going on. What are you doing, children? Are you stealing my butter again? Krishna's friends were so scared to see Mother Yashoda that they forgot all about Krishna at the top and ran from there to avoid a beating.
Crash!
Crash! Down come Krishna, along with his pot of butter as the earthen jar. Shattered on hitting the ground, Krishna was all covered in butter. Krishna slipped and slid till he was back on his feet again and started to run. Mother Yashoda quickly caught hold of him, holding him tightly by her hand. Mother Yashoda dragged Krishna, who was crying and screaming for help now, to a tree in the
courtyard.
I have had enough with you, Krishna. You are becoming very naughty these days. You have to be taught a lesson, she yelled at him in rage. I'm sorry, Mother. I will never try to steal butter again. Please believe me. But Mother Yashoda had
already
made
Hello? made up her mind.
Mind to punish Krishna for his mischievous behavior. She held Krishna firmly by the tree and then took a rope and started tying Krishna around the trunk of the tree. As Mother Yashoda pulled the rope around a tree, she was stunned to find that it was too short. How can that be? This rope is usually long enough to tie a cow to the tree. How did it become so short now? Mother Yashoda asked herself. However, not to be undone, Mother Yashoda brought another piece of rope and started to tie it around the tree again. Alas, the rope turned out to be short this time as well, and there seemed to be no way for her to tie Krishna to the tree. After
several attempts
to tie Krishna had failed, Mother Yashoda
gave up
and cried, "Oh Lord, what is happening to me? I am going mad. Seeing his poor mother's anguish, Krishna finally decided to stop teasing her. He at once stopped playing tricks with the rope, and Mother Yashoda found the rope slowly growing longer in her hands. Mother Yashoda realized that there was something magical about the rope growing longer and shorter, almost as if on wheel. Therefore, she decided not to punish Krishna and instead took him back to the kitchen and gave him a little more butter to eat. Thank you, friend, to watch my video.
Bye.